we mentioned the stages of COPD, and these stages are accompanied by some of the following symptoms. So let's take a look at this, doctor. Shortness of breath, wheezing, tightness in the chest, having to clear your throat a lot, and a chronic cough that may produce mucus. Now, is this something that you're going to have more or one of those symptoms, or could you just have one? Or
you could have just one. And I think the idea that many patients have a constellation of concerns when they come to a pulmonary office means that when they start to have an early presentation for COPD, they may not recognize that as being a flare of a lung condition. Many of my patients have been told they've had acute bronchitis multiple times. And our infectious disease societies have reminded us that anybody with a healthy immune system should really expect to have an acute upper respiratory infection maybe once in a year. Okay. But many of my folks with COPD will present to our practice having two or three bouts of an antibiotic in a year.
Okay, so we went through some of the symptoms. Here's another, the rest of the list, I should say. Blueness of the lips or fingernail bed. Well, that would be obvious. Mm-hmm. Frequent respiratory infections, lack of energy, unintended weight loss, swelling in ankles, feet, and legs. So what's going on that's causing this to happen?
Well, generally, that's going to be some suggestions that the right side of the heart, which is attached to the lung, is starting to fail. And that, unfortunately, for some of our patients, is a consequence of not having adequate therapy early, or more importantly, not being stepped up. We call it maintenance therapy. So the initiation of maintenance therapy early can affect how well patients are able to oxygenate and ventilate and breathe. So the idea that many patients will come to our practices with some degree of heart failure related to their lung condition is generally what those symptoms suggest.